The Dallas Cowboys have fired defensive coordinator Mike Nolan and defensive line coach Jim Tomsula. And joining me now for more is our Cowboys reporter Mike Fisher. And Mike McCarthy hired both of these guys when he took the Cowboys job in 2020. After just one season on the job, why make this change now?
Well, it is highly unusual, and you're right to allude to the relationships that these people have with each other. Mike Nolan is one of Mike McCarthy's best friends. He hired him basically without even interviewing anybody else. Maybe that was a mistake, but let's look at the bottom line here. There was three major errors made that will cause Mike Nolan to have been on the hot seat. And then other coordinators, by the way, like Bones Fossil, who you see, and Kellen Moore, who are staying, avoid the same hot seat. This is, the by the numbers, the worst Cowboy defense in the history of the franchise. Most touchdowns allowed, most points allowed. Number two, the installation of a new defensive scheme with new players that you've never met over Zoom meetings is one of the most ignorant and arrogant things I've ever seen a coaching staff do. It's never been tried before. It'll never be tried again because it's boneheaded. And then number three, and this is very specific, the use of some of the players and the defensive system. They negated Tank Lawrence, who's their best defensive player. And at times, Randy Gregory, their most impactful defensive player, was playing 20% of the snaps. I don't think Jerry Jones liked that very much. So those three factors contribute greatly to the firing today of Mike Nolan and then top defensive assistant Jim Tomsula and probably other defensive staffers quite possibly to come. This, by the way, doesn't make them bad people, doesn't even make them bad coaches. It just means that this year they did a bad job.
I mean, as you mentioned, the 473 points and 57 touchdowns this defense allowed is the most that any unit in the team's 61-season history has allowed. Mike Fisher, any insight into what direction this Cowboys team might be looking next?
Well, one thing that you mentioned on the numbers, a head coach can't stand in front of his players and say, we're accountable, and then give up those kind of numbers and say, but all the coaching staff is safe. You guys are in trouble, but the coaching staff's safe. Marvin Lewis has a history with the Joneses, interviewed last year for the head coaching job, is a Pittsburgh area guy like Mike McCarthy is, and the two of them happened to be together at Pitt in the early 90s when Marvin Lewis was the linebacker coach and Mike McCarthy was coming up as a GA. Joe Witt Jr. almost got the defensive coordinator job a year ago. That's an interesting name. If the Cowboys are smart, they'll do interviews here, not just let McCarthy do it himself, and those interviews can include those kind of names. There's guys across the board that probably should be interviewed, young and old, veteran. And, you know, I want to pick the brain of Wade Phillips. I'm interested in what Raheem Morris has to say about a job like this. I'm interested to see what Coach Quinn, formerly of Atlanta, would have to say about a job like this. Ultimately, though, I almost guarantee you this will not be an FOM, friend of Mike hire. This will be a football hire this time.
A football hire, and we know Mike Fisher will be on top of it as the story evolves. Thanks so much for taking the time.